Hello, 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 hello. Hi, everyone. Hi, viewers. Now we are in a beautiful place in Goa called Dandi. It is located in Agassiz. So what is the very much historical significance of this place is that this has been the principal port of the Kadamba dynasty, which ruled Goa from almost from 10 to 13 centuries for a very long time. And near to this is the pillar where the capital of the Kadamba kings was located, their palace was located. Now it is located a seminary. It is popularly known as Pillar Seminary and a Pillar Church. So at my backside you are seeing a wonderful chapel at the edge of the Dandim. And my backside you can see, like, you know, your beautiful beach over there. It is also known as Dandi Beach, and it's a very, very, very significant place. For example, I would say, like, you know, this small cross over here, what you are seeing, this small cross, actually this has got a very great historical significance. Usually it is the concept that after the Portuguese came to Goa, only the Christianity was introduced. But Father Cosme from Pillar, he has found from this particular place, he had unearthed this particular place, that there was, he found a cross from here, like, you know, which is dated almost like, you know, 9th century AD or something. So it shows that the presence of the Christians even before the arrival of the Portuguese over here, especially as traders. So we are not exactly sure of what sort of Christians they are. Some opinion that they could be of the Saint Bartholomew Christians, that is the Christians who got baptized from Saint Bartholomew when he came to Konkan Coast to preach Christianity. Again, that is disputed. It's only some written accounts we are finding that. Some say that they are the Saint Thomas Christians of Kerala who were baptized by Saint Thomas the Apostle, and they came and settled over here in Dandim. So this could be anything. But there is a concept also called as Manigrama. Manigrama, some of the copper plates of the ancient kings of Goa, such as Shilaras, mentioned the presence of manigramas over here. The manigrama itself is a word from ancient Tamil and Western Coast Tamil, which later became Malayalam, known as the merchant traders. They were all Christians. So it mentions the existence of manigrama in Goa, and it could be equated with the Madagram, which is the it is a Margao. It's a very wonderful, significant place for its beauty, as well as its historical significance, as well as such a kind of great spiritual significance. And the cross, what they have taken from here, has a Palvi letters. Palvi was the language and the script of the Persian Empire. So you can see the Persian Christians could have been active over here evangelizing this place. So it is also said that the Church of India was placed under the control of the Persian bishops. So we can make sure, like, you know, it also gives us the great evidence for a Persian connection with Goa, which is also evidenced in other places such as Chimbal, where coins of Khushru II, the Persian monarch, was found. So you can see, like, you know, what a small place with a very great history. And if you're in Goa, please do make sure that you visit this place for its architectural significance. As I see the beauty of the chapel, as well as its historical legacy. See this small chapel, and for its natural beauty. You can see how beautiful it is over here. And thank you guys for watching this video. And if you want to know more videos like this, please click like, share, comment, subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much. God bless. John at Tertiary Carmelite. Bye.